Yeah.
That was what we are looking for, like they are not moving.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay, yeah. So the first 12, the oldest one, which is our best man to go into the river, are disconnected from the grid at this point in time. So the island just went to spin very slowly. Have you noticed? Where are you from?
He's from Adelaide and I'm from Perth.
Okay. Oh, there you go, nice break. I have a Pakistani cousin by marriage living next door to my dad in Jordan. Unlike most Australians, she appreciates Australia. And she makes you look like a pale face. But no, Argentina has shaken a few cages recently.
Yeah.
And will continue to. Mind you, all of South America is interesting each in its own way.
Mm.
And South American Spanish is slightly different to European Spanish.
It is.
No. I was born in Merritt, British Columbia. Peak steady temperature in that town last day about year was minus 40, about the same Celsius Fahrenheit.
Is it in Canada? Yeah.
British Columbia is the most prominent in Canada.
Yeah.
And right now, it's in the Yukon, which is northwest, have a record snowmass and have had since October last year. There has never been more ice in the year. When it melts, it'll be elsewhere. More weather crazy. It's like standing at about the safest place on the planet.
They're like two different regions, Canada, Australia.
Yeah.
They're like hot or something like all the seasons, but they are like chilly, minus 40, minus 50. All those people, they're like in Vancouver.
Well, I compensated for my birthplace. We might have a teenage years. I lived in Dampier and Carabidoo, which is pretty much the opposite.
Oh, yeah, it's all hot,
yeah.
Dampier and Carabidoo. Carabidoo and Dampier is the, like the... If you go into
way.
The... if you go into the near the Darwin side, right? Or in the north side of the...
It's about halfway between here and Darwin.
Yeah.
So if you hop on the roundabout at the top of York Street, hang your nose down the highway and drive at the speed limit non-stop, 54 hours, where are you? Darwin. You're standing in a state 4 times the size of Texas, which is just close to each other.
Yeah.
1/3 of the area of Australia, which means Canberra usually ignores us.
I think that for Darwin, we have to go through Perth, or we can go from the centre. But I don't know, like, there is there any fuel stations in the centre?
Through the guts, no fuel stations.
Yeah.
To turn off to the... there's a highway back to the desert.
Yeah.
And to turn off to the highway advisor, the next fuel stop is 465 kilometres. So.
Oh, damn.
See, in Europe, if you drive for 20 minutes, you might be 2 nations from where you started.
Yeah.
Australia, if you drive for 20 minutes, you might or might not get to the end of the driveway.
So that's when you have to fill up the tank and you have something like in the jerry can to fill up the fuel tank. Otherwise, if you stuck it in the desert, there was nothing.
In some places, not even tap tank. Well, Dad was working on one of the early Brockman lines, right? This guy is his hottest day ever.
Brockman, which one? Brockman 2?
Brockman. The westernmost of the sites, a number of this. Before the Brockman sites were built, he and the geologists were venturing north of Tom Price to do some measurements. Late one morning, they measured the interstate temperature from the further south side of the dip at 53.7 Celsius.
Oh,
so when they went back into Tom Price for lunch, they fetched back an egg, selected the first heat and got
shhh.
Their friends originally from Idaho, which in Australia means potatoes and US meant diamond, same place. He worked for several years in Saudi Arabia, in inland town. It was not uncommon for a day to hit 54 Celsius, followed by a minimum of 7, followed by another match, and another 50, followed by another minimum of less than 10, followed by, he's a category that you lose it real fast.
Yeah. Well, the desert area, in the day, there's a very hot temperature, at night it's like windy, chilly, and something.
And there's one nation in the middle of South America, Paraguay? It has the largest European cultural continent. Content in the entire South America, because a lot of people during times of crisis fled from Europe to, I think it's Paraguay.
I hear there's a new, it's not about Australia, but new Australia?
South American Australia.
Yeah.
But you're standing on the world's second largest island.
Yeah.
The largest island is Greenland, there's a whole story behind that one.
Yeah.
On the 10th of June this year, the Danes and Canada settled a difference that has been standing since 1973. When they separated Greenland from North America, because Greenland is the largest island, they drew a line down the strait. They were right on the line of Denmark and then left the line of Canada. The line went straight across the middle of Hans Island. so a Canadian animal stuck a Canuck flag on a stand on the top of the island, especially with a big rock like that, and a bottle of Canadian whiskey and a little letter claiming the island. The next year, a Danish animal stopped that for a bottle of schnapps and another Danish flag. And this continued year after year after year since, until this year, they finally settled the difference. And Brazil has its own place in fame as well. And the world owes most of its mass to the sub-Indian continent, and won't admit it. The world owes most of its mass to the sub-Indian continent, won't admit it. And there's a glassified area of ground, across of Bombay. I think it's 40 square kilometres. The amount of energy expended in glassified area of ground is equivalent to an atomic bomb, but it's not right for an atomic bomb. So the primitive Indian subcontinent, you know, primitive Indian subcontinent people were playing with huge amounts of energy way back when. But the Americans are proud of Niagara Falls. You know about Positive Cabo? On the Amazon River, bordering between Brazil and Peru, I think. Seven times the flow of the other side of it, up the end, so much more spectacular.
We have done amazing falls, and they're called Brazil and Argentina.
And opposites in continents. Right now, southeastern Australia equals Victoria, is worst floods in more than 50 years. Southeastern USA, Mississippi, is so droughted they've had to close the lower form of the river barges. Is not simple. It's both a corporation and a nation. And their annual military spend is equal to more than the total of the next seven smaller military spends around the world, probably the next common empire.
Yeah.
Racially, I'm half British Australian, one quarter Austrian, one eighth French, one eighth Scots, so European bitter. And have local friends where the husband is Belgian. And the wife who's British Australian ancestry, born in the Netherlands. Have local Zambian friends? Zambia?
Zambia, no.
And
you have a lot of fire from
Well, I think Australia's got the US real for melting pot of all nations.
Yeah.
We go and have a chat to some of the people in the Sudanese suburbs in Perth.
Yeah, there are a lot of. Yeah, I'm from Perth, I know that like there are a lot of people like Perth.
Yeah. And big city drivers, including Perth, seem to know nothing about physics. And a few times on the big roundabout in town, two lanes, it's the only roundabout in Western Australia where you're allowed to change lanes on the way around.
Oh, really?
The reason is when Albany Highway North exit happened, just after that you got South Coast Highway, less than 20 metres. There is a house on that corner with a driveway exiting onto the roundabout itself. If you want roundabout hell, that would be good one.
Okay.
You have roundabouts in roundabouts and a raise of roundabouts, you know. But apparently an Irish country road is a driving experience because they're one car wide. Not one truck, not two cars, one car. Occasionally two cars wide, so cars in opposite directions to the car. If you drive off the road, you're 7 feet deep in peace. Good luck to the traction. But, 4 August ago, I wandered up to Castle Rock. As I come up the bottom, I met a Canadian tourist coming down from the top who's taking dawn photos with his phone. And on the way down, I met a bloke coming back up who's anxious, who's obvious by his accent. This homeland was still part of the EU, not part of the UK. In town later that day, I met another bloke, similar accent. This homeland was still part of the UK, not part of the EU. Anyway, that book seems to be hit on text and things. It's been hopping its foot in a few times.
Yeah, I think the human over there. Yeah. He's trying to move forward, but he's stuck with the reins. Yeah.
Oh no, he's actually hovering. He's exciting something on the ground. If you want serious exercise, go and park under wind energy converter 15, which is what some pretty beside of these things should be called. Took the rest down the motorbike track to what used to be Prescott Vale Road and Guthrie to the coast. At the coast there is a sign saying beach access. That's the infrastructure. Don't go down there on a rainy day because the modern two-thirds is one-on-one standings. Vegetation covered sandy soil, so getting back up is dramatic. But right down the bottom, the coast, about 1.5 miles west, is very sandy. cave going into the sandstone and hold the rocks and that sort of thing. Whatever, so have an opinion, this is the best country town in Australia.
Yeah.
I'm like George Markel Groovy, it's not on the wave anyway.
Yeah.
And in terms of safety, a friend of a local friend who used to be very high up in the US military security, when he retired, bought a farm outside Wilpole. What does that tell you about the place? Just that one action. With humans, you ignore what they say, watch what they do. Often a big difference. Our best friend in high school was Tuscan, so I learned a fair bit of Italiano. Quite a simple language, that would be it. I don't even need 26 letters in the alphabet, you get by with 24. What you see is what you say, completely phonetic. And foods are interesting because a word ending in O or U is male, ending in at or et is female. Similar to Spanish, not the same. Yeah? So spaghetti is long and thin. Ravioli is small and round. Lasagna is a big square blob. Anything long and thin or small and round is male, anything shaped is a swimmer. French is worse because the word for chair is female and the word for table is male, and the reason for that is the table goes on the chair. And every French speaking country in the world except Canada. If you want to say computer, you have to say ordinateur, because that's what the Indian side of the word was for computer. But in Canada, you can get away with computer, it's fine.
I think South Africa is a mixture of like most of the people are coming from the US and to Canada.
Well, quite a few are actually.
But if you go to the Quebec and say the computer, they might not understand it.
Yes, no, tools are basically amplifiers. So if you want a problem, put a computer, if you want to amplify the problem, add a computer.
Yeah.
Which is why I very much prefer to use manual checkout registers rather than automated self-service.
Yeah.
With the computer, your choices are, it works, it doesn't, it works. Anyway, I've taken some video of some wind things not moving, so I'll go and get the camera and wander off the end there. You can see some photos without this one dominating. From my brother out there, we use them for slideshows. Geology people have no imagination. That is Coney Island. Next island, west east along the coast, are Green Islands, off Sharp Point. Not because it's Sharp, it's named after the same Mr. Sharp as Sharp Street in Wellington over there. But anyone who reckons English is simple, it's simple. One of the 87 line rules is I before E, except after C. This, of course, carries no weight into starting a feisty feist against a weird beige flying beast of the neighbour, and I'm sure you can find more reasons over there. And if you don't believe the British Isles have been invaded by every nation in Europe, just consider the language. Like a lot of our swear words. Right from German and a little bit of French. And American English tends to be one of the favourite ones is when you attach electronic components to a circuit board, the process is called soldering.
Yeah,
in the US it's spelt the same way as the rest of the world, which is pronounced soda.
Oh.
They leave the L out with the sun. Now this must cause some confusion because depending on which state you're in, the soft drink here is either pot or soda. Anyway, I'll go fix the camera, enjoy your day, and we'll cheer us here again.
Thank you so much.